You think that you're gonna have justice? Make them all pay.
5 years ago, Riley North just disappeared. Completely off the grid.
So she spends the last 5 years doing what?
Training.
Well, that's new. You honestly think Riley North did this?
Today's the 5-year anniversary of her family's murder. She's back.
What is up, guys? This is Ray from Rated R Reviews. Thank you so much for watching another one of my videos. I truly, truly appreciate it. Please subscribe, like, hit the bell notification. I try to drop at least one video a week. So this week, I'm going to actually review a movie that came out earlier in the year because I can't really watch every single movie because, you know, life takes over and stuff like that. So the movie I'm reviewing this week is Peppermint. Peppermint stars Jennifer Garner. Peppermint is a strong story. The best line that I could possibly use to describe this movie without getting too into it is the fact that it's an evolution of a character who's on a trail of revenge. Jennifer Garner's character, she plays a young woman named Riley who has a family, a happy family life, and things are going well in one sense, but bad in another. So the husband tries to take on a job that's a bit more than he can chew, and then he decides after a minute, like, you know what, I can't do this. I'm not going to go through this. So he kind of backs out of the job he's supposed to do. So Riley wakes up in a coma. She's in the hospital. She's being questioned by some police officers. And she starts getting these flash visions of seeing the people that did what they did to her family. And in this moment, she lets the police try to stop them. She lets the judicial system try to stop them. She lets the FBI try to stop them. And the thing is that nothing is stopping them because these criminals are so well interconnected that she just can't get to them. She just, there's no legal way to get to them. So she kind of just like fades into the background of life and disappears for a few years and goes around the world learning these different skills. Let me tell you something. Jennifer Garner played a badass in a couple other movies. And she was always in great shape, always looked great. But some movies kind of failed. Peppermint is one of those movies that the movie did not fail. It had a great action sequence after great action sequence. A great story, great driven character. Death and love are the two strongest forces that someone can use to drive themselves to go do things every single day. And this movie, the writers use it in a very dark manner to create this like anti-hero out of this everyday person, you know what I mean? So it's like kind of that driving force that she had to murder or get back at these people because of what they did, or at least to attempt to do this, you know what I mean? The way it was shot was great. The acting was great. I love the cinematography of it. I like the action sequences a lot because I believe Jennifer Garner was this angry person and she did all this stuff. The only thing about the movie that kind of fell off a little bit for me was how they represented the passing of time throughout the movie, because sometimes you kind of got lost in the story and what was going on and you kind of like realized, like, wait a minute, oh okay, now they let you know that a few years have passed when you're thinking it's kind of like along the same days from the original timeline of the story. Had a good, solid story. Good, solid performance by Garner. Actually, I think she did. She gave a great performance. The action sequences I liked. The badassery was awesome. So, for action, in the action movie genre, on a scale of 1 to 10, I have to give Peppermint, like, a solid 8. I really enjoyed the movie a lot. I would definitely see it again. Highly do recommend this movie. So, yeah. Did you guys see Peppermint? If you didn't, go check it out. Because right now, it's on Hulu, it's on Google Play, it's on YouTube. Well, YouTube, you have to pay for it to see. I think it's like $13, something like that. But on Google Play, I think you can rent it for about $2 or $3, $3.99 or something like that. Definitely worth the time. Hope you guys watch it. Hope you guys enjoy it. Please leave comments below. Let me know what you thought of the movie. Let me know if you want to see, if you want me to review a movie that's older that, you know, maybe I haven't seen, but I don't know, you guys love or anything like that, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. I'm Ray from Rated R Reviews. Thank you so much. Like, subscribe, bell notification. You know what it is. Later.